top 10 Toho monsters other than Godzilla. What's up, guys? So, as it says in the title, today we're counting down our list of the top 10 monsters or kaiju from Toho other than the King of the Monsters. Now, do note that the ranking of the kaiju in this list is based on a mixture of use in the movies, appearance, powers, and personality. So it's not really a ranking based purely on power or popularity, but it rather depends on factors that make each of these monsters stand out, or rather become an even more interesting opponent or ally for the Big G. With that clear, let's get right into it. Number 10. Space Godzilla. Space Godzilla is Godzilla's penultimate foe in the Heisei series of the films, as well as the only extraterrestrial creature introduced in that series. Now, of course, initially the name may sound pretty lame, and even his visual appearance is sometimes summed up as Godzilla with crystals on his shoulders. But let's not judge a book by its cover. After all, Space Godzilla is actually considered to be one of Godzilla's most powerful foes. In the film, even Godzilla was quickly defeated by his space clone in their first encounter, and the Big G required help from Mogera to finally defeat him. Unlike Godzilla, who in the Heisei series of films is depicted as a force of nature, neither good nor evil, Space Godzilla appears to have an element of true malice. Also, fun fact, Space Godzilla's flying form weighs a massive 720,000 metric tons, making Space Godzilla the heaviest known monster in the entire Godzilla franchise. Number 9. Hedorah. Just as Godzilla was born from anxieties about nuclear war, Hedorah was created as a warning against the dangers of environmental disaster. Power is not simply why Hedorah is on the list, although it certainly helps. The smog monster is on this list for being one of Godzilla's most threatening opponents. Not just for kaiju, but the human casualties in the film were gruesome and unlike anything the franchise had seen before. Beginning as a huge tadpole-like creature, Hedorah transformed into a terrestrial form and came ashore in Japan, where it battled Godzilla. Continuing to grow and evolve, Hedorah took on an airborne form capable of spreading clouds of toxic mist, and finally a colossal bipedal form that dwarfed even Godzilla. You can't shoot Hedorah, bullets just go through him. And punching is not a good idea either, as he's made of acid and will melt all your soft tissues. Some attacks, like Godzilla's mighty atomic breath, just fail. It's hard to poison a giant blob of poison. Number 8. Destroyer. The Oxygen Destroyer. It has the power to destroy everything in its path. Destroyer. So, what makes this kaiju particularly unique is the fact that this evil monstrosity is arguably by far the most powerful foe that Godzilla's ever faced. Unlike monsters that kill and destroy unintentionally and act only out of instinct or under mind control, Destroyer seems fully aware of the death and destruction he causes and takes pleasure out of causing it. Destroyer is a demonic, wicked-looking opponent for the King of the Monsters. His multi-form evolution is a great dynamic. His powers interesting and powerful enough to give the supercharged burning Godzilla trouble. However, his true claim to fame is killing Godzilla Jr., making his battle very personal for the King of the Monsters. And Destroyer clearly deserves a comfortable 8th spot in our list today. Number 7. Anguirus. Anguirus was Godzilla's first ever opponent and battled him to the death in Osaka in Godzilla Raids Again. Anguirus was ultimately killed by Godzilla, but a second individual debuted in the film Destroy All Monsters in 1968. With a more down-to-earth appearance, Anguirus became a friend and ally to Godzilla, loyally fighting alongside him to fend off alien monsters such as King Ghidorah and Gigan. While not as popular as the likes of Rodan, Mothra, or King Ghidorah, Anguirus has become a popular monster in his own right and has earned a reputation as being both Godzilla's closest friend and as a tenacious fighter even when severely outmatched. What made him particularly endearing was his determination and loyalty to Godzilla, giving the franchise a much-needed underdog for Godzilla to work alongside. Number 6. Gigan. While the alien invasion concept was not new to the Godzilla lore when Gigan came about, he was one of the few extraterrestrial beasts capable of making the king literally bleed. Gigan's debut film, including the feature itself, was immensely inspired by comic book culture showing in the film's tone, characters, and outrageous plot, but also Gigan's characteristics in design. With large, hook-like blades, a buzzsaw in his stomach, and blades on his mouth, Gigan is a force to be reckoned with. When he was reawakened as Godzilla's ultimate foe in Final Wars, it was seen only fit that he be repaired and his scythe hands replaced by giant chainsaws. We certainly love that, and if you ask our opinion on this monster, Gigan is punk rock incarnate. Number 5. Biollante. The kaiju that sent young kids screaming in terror from the living room, Biollante was the largest opponent Godzilla had ever fought at the time, and this plant-type beast had a mouth shaped like a crocodile with vines all over its body. Now, if this was a list of the scariest-looking kaijus, Biollante would have surely taken the top spot. This incredible kaiju was the result of a genetic splicing of a human flower and Godzilla DNA, and certainly looks like it. Biollante is a massive, amazing-looking, plant-like creature with lethal attack vines, dozens of teeth, and the ability to regenerate. As a character, Biollante is also one of the very few female creatures in the franchise, with her human element bringing a new twist. Number 4. Rodan. Rodan the Fire Demon is undeniably one of the most iconic Toho kaiju till date. Named for the Japanese name for a pterodon, Radon, Rodan is a historic beast who remained preserved beneath the earth and was awoken by a mining excavation in Kitsamatsu. Rodan then migrated into Godzilla's turf and, as one of the few kaiju completely resilient to Godzilla's atomic ray attacks, became one of the King of the Monsters' most useful allies with shockwave abilities and Mach speed travel. The Samurai of the Sky is a simplistic design done right. Furthermore, his unlikely alliance with Godzilla proved an interesting dynamic compared to the partners the King of the Monsters had since. Number 3. Mechagodzilla. One of the most powerful foes to match that of Godzilla's Mechagodzilla has been built and rebuilt to challenge the King of the Monsters time and time again, and equally for invasions of the planet Earth. The mechanized clone of the Big G is armed with the most and the highest caliber weaponry, and had rigid silver armor created to be reminiscent of the samurai of Edo, Japan. Mechagodzilla's reputation as a force to be reckoned with is backed up by the fact that Godzilla hasn't always been able to beat him alone. So by now, it should be pretty clear what to expect from Godzilla vs. Kong, and if Mechagodzilla does make an appearance, which it will be the 5th Toho kaiju to join the Monsterverse. Number 2. King Ghidorah. The entire human race will perish from the Earth. When the monster Ghidorah passes, only flaming ruins are left. Such is the threat that Ghidorah poses. After all, he's the one who is many. Widely considered to be Godzilla's arch-nemesis, King Ghidorah made his debut in Ghidorah, the Three-Headed Monster, where he arrived on Earth inside of a meteor and prepared to destroy it, just as he'd done to Venus thousands of years in the past. One of the most iconic Godzilla characters, featuring a simple but great design, King Ghidorah was the first big bad the franchise had. It took the combined might of Godzilla and Rodan to defeat him from an alliance formed by Mothra's efforts. A cackling, chaotic space monster, King Ghidorah didn't have a lot of personality, but was brutally efficient at leveling cities and proving a large foil to the hero and anti-hero monsters of the series. Although, that's still not good enough to give it the title of number 1. Which brings us to the final Toho monster. Number 1. Mothra. Toho's second most popular character and the only Toho monster outside of Godzilla with enough appeal to headline her own franchise. Mothra's role among the roster of Toho monsters is like that of a phoenix in that she's reborn as one previously laid larva when she falls in battle. Regarded as a divine kaiju, Mothra has the ability to communicate with other living beings psychically. Mothra's major distinction among Toho's library of kaiju, aside from being the first female monster in the Godzilla series, is her benevolent nature and relationship to mankind. While other monsters frequently menace humanity with their very existence, Mothra fights to protect humanity from monsters that threaten it. What makes the character number 1 on the list? At her best, she excels as a deity, a representative to a nation of people who can call upon her to intervene in kaiju affairs. Now, quite a lot of people scoff at the concept of Mothra versus Godzilla, 1964, on the grounds that the insect god is outmatched by Godzilla. But that's really what makes her great. She is hopelessly underpowered against Godzilla, yet her determination and self-sacrifice makes the character loved by fans. So that was The Last Blast. We hope you enjoyed the video. If you want to keep watching more videos like these, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.